have telltale signs of communication from other drivers, like heads turning, tailgating, and turn signals.
Heads turning? How is that communication?
If a driver turns his head, expect them to turn or change lanes.
Tailgating?
Yes, tailgating. Tailgating is a form of communication and not a very nice one at that.
What's he trying to say?
I think he's trying to say, pardon me, might I pass there, chap?
Ugh, I can definitely feel the rudeness.
Now, what would you think it means if a driver coming from the opposite direction was flashing their headlights?
Coppers ahead!
No! Well, yes, no.
We will not condone flashing headlights as a form of communication to be translated into police detection. We now return you to your regularly scheduled course.
Flash your headlights to communicate with other drivers on the opposite side of the road that there's a problem up ahead.
I thought the coppers was the problem.
No, you're the problem. They're the solution. Use your headlights to signal to other drivers that there's a wreck, a washout, or sudden ice, or any other emergency ahead of them.
Hello. Here are some more ways you can use to communicate with others on the road from the comfort and safety of your own car. If you are trying to alert another driver of danger, hold down your horn. To alert drivers behind you of potential dangers ahead, tapping your brakes will flash your taillights. If you are having car trouble, turn on your emergency or hazard lights ASAP. If there is no danger and you are trying to get someone's attention, tap on your horn lightly. Use eye contact or hand signals to indicate why you want their attention. Say danke by giving a friendly wave. Hello, Dieter. Lastly, one of the most archaic forms of communication, the turn signal. In most states, it is the law that you apply your turn signal 100 feet before making a turn. But that is just a minimum. Don't turn your turn signal on too late. Others need time to react to you. At higher speeds, turn on your turn signal much further in advance of your turn. A good rule of thumb is to put your turn signal on when you lift your foot off the gas pedal to start your braking point. Signaling also gives others warning of where you are going. Remember, the distance to your turn and the length of time you use your turn signal is relative.
But when I put my turn signal on to change lanes, they speed up and don't let me in.
No excuse, I say. Use turn signals.
But I can't text and use my turn signals at the same time.
Text? What's text?
How should I know? It's 1913.
No matter, I'm still not buying it. Use your turn signals.
What if I'm going somewhere top secret? Do I have to use my turn signals then?
Nonetheless, use your turn signals today. If you don't inform others of your intentions on the road, don't be surprised if they try to communicate with you and give you the what's for by using eye contact and hand gestures.
Roger Ruddy here with my esteemed color man, Nick Nock. What a day, what a day.
That's right, Roger. Weather looks good. Field of vision at its best. Traffic seems to be at its peak. Four-lane road, dry conditions. Can't go wrong on a day like this.
Oh, wait. It looks like we have a little problem down here on the pavement.
Yes. We have an improper use of hand signaling while driving. Now, everybody knows that with the wrong hand signal, accidents can happen.
Well, you're right there, my friend.
Ooh, and speaking of right, let's see the proper right turn signal from the driver's seat.
I haven't seen such precision hand movement since Miss Johnson made that right turn at 4th and Main.
Yes, that was a beautifully executed hand signal if I've ever seen one.
Speaking of hand signals, how about that sporty left hand number?
That was incredible. Let's see that again with instant replay.
And don't forget about the stop or slowing down signal. Hand and arm downward, palm to the rear, like this. And there's the horn, which is a warning signal. It calls attention to what the motorist is doing. And speaking of horns, did you know that emergency vehicles are the only ones allowed to use sirens, whistles, and bells?
Cowbells?
No, bells like this.
Well, there you go, folks. I don't know about you, but knowing the proper hand signals and horns goes a long way on the road. Did you know under normal conditions, the horn should be able to be heard for at least 200 feet?
Oh look, the ref is giving the all ahead full sign.
Well, that's it for today, folks. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.
A motorist should always give a proper signal when turning, changing lanes, stopping, or slowing down.
I'll tell you what, man, I gave a hand signal once and I got slapped.
Most vehicles have turn signals and a motorist should always use them.
I misled a date once and I got slapped again.
A motorist should turn on the turn signal at least 100 feet before turning and be sure to cancel the signal after making a turn. Not doing so could mislead other motorists. Law requires a motorist to know the correct hand signals for stopping and turning, which are standard in all states.